Thank you for watching videos by FamilyTravelPhotos.com. In this episode, I will begin a series of videos that prepare you to fly the Yuneec Q500 4K by showing you the initial steps you must take once you receive your aircraft. This episode is part of a series of videos designed to help you complete a safe and successful first flight with your Yuneec Q500. These episodes apply to the Q500 4K and the Q500 Plus. With very few exceptions, this series applies to the Typhoon G as well. I'll cover initial setup, pre-flight steps, and a step-by-step walkthrough of your first flight, along with more suggestions to make your flying even safer. Tips that could save you thousands of dollars in the event of an accident. More videos of interest to Yuneec Q500 owners are in the works. Be sure to subscribe so you know when those videos are posted. Let's get started with episode 1, initial setup. The first thing you should do when you get your Q500, obviously, is read your manual, quick start guide, and other materials. This is not one of those situations where you should figure things out on your own. That's a great way to smash your $1,000 drone into a tree. You don't get a printed manual with your Q500. Instead, you get a file on the included media card, which is probably out of date. Follow the links in my description below to find the latest version of the manual in PDF format. Next, visit the website knowbeforeyoufly.com and read through their information about safe and legal flying. Violating the laws about flying could get you fined and thrown in jail. Know the rules by reading this site. It only takes a few minutes. The link is below. Now let's set up things with the Q500. Before each flight, you need to charge the flight battery. To charge, connect the balancing smart charger, the power supply, and the charge lead extension that you received with your aircraft. Plug that into the wall socket and connect them with the battery. A battery can take 90 minutes to charge fully. Three important points. Never leave a battery unattended as it is charging, and do not plug the battery in for charging overnight. This is dangerous. LiPo batteries have been known to start fires. Plug your battery in and check it periodically. The balancing smart charger will flicker green and red as it charges. You will receive a solid green light when charging is complete. Once you see the green light, unplug the battery from the charger immediately. Second, the charger that comes with the Yuneec Q500 is awful. It takes too long to charge and it does a poor job. Follow this link for a video that describes a better charger you can buy that charges two batteries at once and does a great job. Third, don't charge the battery and let it sit for a week or two. Over time, leaving your battery with a full charge will cause it to lose its ability to charge fully. Charge the battery right before you plan to use it. Follow this practice and help your battery to take and hold full charges for many, many flights. While your battery is charging, you should also charge your ST10 Plus transmitter. You can use the USB cable provided with your Q500 and plug it into a USB port on your computer or into the wall socket with a USB adapter. The blue light will blink as the transmitter charges and will show a solid blue when it's done charging. The transmitter may require 2 or more hours to charge. Fortunately, this charge will last for several flights. Now you should perform a firmware update on your aircraft and on your transmitter. I'll provide links below to videos that show this process in greater detail. Once your firmware is updated, it's time for calibrations. Your Q500 has already traveled thousands of miles, shipping from China to your retailer to you. It's a good idea to calibrate your accelerometer before your first flight. This takes about 30 seconds, and then you don't have to do it again unless you notice the aircraft isn't hovering properly or you update your firmware. You should also calibrate your compass before your first flight and after every firmware update. I'll provide links below to videos that show both processes in greater detail. Now it's time to insert the media card into the camera. Remove the gimbal lock, then hold the camera gently without touching the lens and rotate it until the media card slot is accessible. Insert the media card into the slot with the label facing backwards. The card can only go in one way, so if it doesn't click into place, flip the card around. Push the card in all the way until it clicks into place. With these steps completed, you're ready to head out for your first flight with the Q500. I hope you found this video to be helpful. I'm posting other videos that are linked below, and I hope you'll watch those as well. You can help me in return by hitting the like button below and subscribing. This helps my videos to rank higher at YouTube, and you'll be notified when I release more videos of interest to Q500 pilots in the future. Your feedback in the comment section below is greatly appreciated. Thanks for watching.